Hi to Haven. Thanks for being here with me today.
Hello. Thank you for having me here today. I appreciate it.
So I'm excited to talk about your exhibit, Radon Daughter, that's at the Indian Pueblo Cultural Center right now. But I wanted to start with a little bit about you.
Okay. Well, I'm originally born and was originally born in Portsmouth, Virginia. My dad was stationed out there in the Marine Corps. So that's where I was born. And then we gradually moved back to California again. That's where my dad was stationed in Camp Pendleton. But then periodically we'd go back to Laguna Pueblo and stay with my family out there. That was my grandparents and my uncle. So I really enjoyed that part because, you know, you get to see the different, I guess, the aspects of how living like culturally and then living often on the reservation, I guess it would be. So I really enjoyed it, and but I enjoyed being on the Pueblo more so because I got to spend time with my, like I said, my grandparents and relatives.
Can you describe the landscape at Pueblo of Laguna, maybe for people who've never been there before, or like what that landscape especially looked to you like when you were a kid or growing up?
Well, I mean, what I remember and what I saw was just mesas everywhere. I mean, I lived in, or they lived in the village of Paguate, which is located right in Laguna Pueblo. And what I saw was just various shapes of, you know, mesas and, you know, cedar trees and just really pretty. But then when I looked maybe to the south, I saw, you know, the uranium mine, which I thought at the time when I was young, I thought it was more or less resembled a big ant pile, how it just teared into one big giant thing. But I didn't, you know, at that time I didn't know that's what it was. Later on, consider it one of the world's largest open pit uranium mines. And it was less than 1,000 feet away from where my grandparents lived.
Can you talk about what it was like to have the mine so close?
It felt like, you know, just this man-made anthill, basically, just a man-made anthill out there. But when the sirens would go off, you know, that meant like everybody would close their doors and, you know, shut everything up because depending on how the wind was blowing, the wind would come from the mine. And of course, all the little particles and everything would float towards the Pueblo. And so that's basically how I just saw everything. And then when the cloud blew, the dust would rise up, and it just seemed to me like a dragon, you know, turning over in his sleep, and like kind of, you know, why am I being waken up? And this dust plumes come up, just like how the dragons would, you know, have the fumes come up. So it was like that. It was just kind of almost a fairy tale in a sense, but then also the reality of, later on, I would know the reality of what it really was.
I was reading about the mine. It operated from the 1950s to the 1980s, and so it's been closed now for 40 years, but still hasn't been cleaned up. Can you talk a little bit about the other the impacts that the mine has had on the community and people's health?
The impacts have been probably cancer, the main one, and a lot of illnesses. Illnesses that maybe we never really saw, or the people never saw. That was really kind of just traumatizing. Just taking, you know, everything it saw, the trees dying, everything being monitored, you know, now like with the EPA. So it became very scary, you know. But like I said, when you're small, you don't really see those things until you're older. And I just remember, you know, people passing away, you know, including from my own family, from things we never even heard of. So it was really it was really sad and strange at the same time.
Through your pieces that are on exhibit, when people look at that exhibit, Radon Daughter, as a whole, mm-hmm. what do you hope that they take away from that?
I hope they take away, I guess maybe in a sense, it's a warning. I would like to say it's a warning, because I know people had contacted other areas to see if they were interested in drilling again. And so I think there were boreholes, and I was like, no. You know, we already went through that previously. A lot of people passed away. A lot of people are dealing with cancer, children with various illnesses. So it's not, I don't think it's a really good thing.
So this piece is called Radon Daughter, is mm-hmm. that right?
Yes.
Can you talk a little bit about this piece and who's here and where?
Okay, well, this is all the pieces that I have are reflected around the landscape, in the landscape of Paguate, because of the man-made mesas. Some are there, you know, by nature, but some have been built, you know, because of the reconstruction of the landscape. But this one, I had my daughter in there, and how she was looking out over the landscape, and how we had the clouds, the blue clouds in the background coming down and with the rain, and then it kind of dissipates into, you know, with the uranium coming up, or yellow cake. That's the purest form of uranium. So you see them both collide in the middle. And then my daughter, I did an abstract image of her with the rain coming down on one side. So it's like she's looking over into the landscape, or a part of the landscape, actually. And so that's what she's doing in this painting.
Hummingbirds make frequent appearances in your paintings. Can you talk about the hummingbird?
Yes, the hummingbird in most cultures is perceived as a good omen, and it brings a lot of messages of hope and happiness. That's what I've read, and of course I understand, but this one is on a personal level. This was I think hummingbirds came into my life soon after the passing of my two-year-old son, and it was awful. I mean, the whole aspect of it. He had been fighting a horrible illness, and later on, like at 2 years old, just succumbed to it. And my mom had told me that she, maybe 2 weeks or maybe a couple days after he had passed away, that there was a little tiny bird at the window, and he was clawed on and singing a beautiful little song. And my mom told me, she said, I called all your family, yeah, the rest of the family, and that bird, for some reason, just stayed there. And he kept singing and singing. And so my mom, in our language, she spoke to the little bird, and she said that it was like as if the bird was telling her, tell my mom and my sister I'm okay. And she just believed it was my little boy, Sky. And everybody came in, and they listened to that, you know, the little bird before he decided to go. And everybody's in tears, and they just felt like, man, how amazing and how blessed and fortunate that we know that he's okay. So from then on, the hummingbird just played into a majority of my work. And I just felt like how strong of a presence he is. So with this image, here it is, you find, you know, with the uranium and the mining going on, the hummingbird kind of like almost breaks apart. But yet again, he's coming together because of the rain. And the rain symbolism always brings, like he's washing away all the sadness. And he wants everything to come back together with the terms of rebirth. You know, the landscape, animals, vegetables, trees, other plant life, that everything comes back together and is healed. So I always think of the hummingbird in this image, he's coming back together. You know, he's going to be formed as one and go deliver his messages of, you know, hope and whatnot. So yeah, this is another favorite of mine. So,
well, thank you for sharing your art with everyone, and mm-hmm. And thanks for sharing your time with me today.
Oh, thank you. I really appreciate it too. Thank you so much.